Okay, so we own the reels. Now what we found here was a bunch of license plates. And this is the, even though it's a turd, you know, people still buy the old blue plates. But he wants too much money for them, so I'm going to have to pass. But we do own the reel now all the time. He's hustling like me. So now we got another Nintendo. We saw that a while ago, and the guy wanted 20. So we're going to see what Gabriel wants. Hey, well, how much for the Nintendo?
You mean 20.
Okay. Let me think. See, everybody's 20 on a non-working Nintendo. Pass. Stop. It's just an empty case. Sometimes you can find some instruments, which are super cool. I've made some good money on clarinets, and you just got to watch for them. Hey, you see that old pedal car back there? That's a reproduction. But if you can find the older ones, for especially you guys back in the Midwest, those are worth some definite money. Again, like when you're coming, always bring your loop with you. You never know what you're going to find. You know, when you're looking around on tables, again, you know, you never know. Like, there's a turquoise Harley ring. There's some Harley stuff in there. An eagle. You know, you see kind of a pattern here. But then you look over here, and what is really cool is you got the old bullshit belt buckle. I used to have one of those when I was in high school. So, again, you never know. Anything weird, obscure, and different, you know. A bunch of blank keys. You know, old keys. If you can find old church keys, skeleton keys, you know, those are worth money if you can buy those in chunks of lots. But, you know, a bunch of nice old turquoise rings with their silver. I'll take a closer look at them here, but, you know, again, a pattern. Hey guys, sometimes look at some of these old receivers. Sometimes they're worth money and sometimes they're not. So let's take a look around. You know, there's an old amp. He's got video cameras that are really not worth stuff. See, there's a stock radio there, like an OEM. Look out for some of that stuff. Sometimes it can be worth some money. I always keep your eye open. Like, here's some wooden shaft golf clubs. Watch out for those little hickory sticks. If you can pick them up cheap enough, you know, you can sell those for, you know, 8, 10, 12 bucks, and if they're really rare, even more. Hey, books. Sometimes books can be worth some money. Be really, really careful. Now, this might be a nice old book, you know. You know, look and see how old they are. Doesn't waste a whole bunch of time on a 25-cent book. So, but when you're looking for books, look for old ones. Go in and do a little thing on eBay. Type in, you know, vintage book and see what you come up with. And then, you know, make it a case study for you. And so you know what to look for when you're out here. You know, you never know what you're going to run into. You always got to just keep looking. You know, sometimes there's a lot of guys out there, and you can make this a part of your business if you want, is books, believe it or not. I mean, it's kind of crazy, but they always have, we'll have the scanner on the back of it, and if you have the app on your phone, you can find out what it's all worth real quick. And, you know, the trick of selling books, see, somebody paid $27.95 for that book when it was brand new. And, you know, when you can pick these things up for a quarter, you can sell them for $1.99 on eBay and, you know, charge $4 for shipping, make a couple bucks off of shipping. Some people do it that way. So just a little, you know, something for you. Go look at some of the bookstores on eBay where they'll have a feedback rating of 10,000 and they'll sell 4,000 books a month, 10 grand a month. But boy, you got to have one hell of a setup to be able to pull that off. So, anyways, just a little something for you.
When you're out picking in places like this, make sure you got all your business cards with you. Because just particularly just a minute ago, I was digging through those books, and there was a lady that was digging through them too. And I started talking to her, like, hey, you like books? Yeah, my books. I'm like, look, I got like 350, 400 books. So if you're a book buyer and you're interested in books, I got a bunch of books for sale. So I gave her my card. And you know what? And she called me. I've handed out 6 or 7 business cards today. I see guys that they're here with spaces that I see at storage shed auctions, that I see at garage sales, I see at estate sales. I even ran into a guy that bought some crap from on Craigslist. So you never know who you're going to see And networking is huge. So that's just how this works. So anyways, I just want to share that with you real quick.
Again, here, and let's talk about, you know, DVDs, trading cards. You know, I've seen, 5,000 games and DVDs here today. Believe it or not, even some of the old Walt Disney VHS tapes will sell. But you literally have to buy them for pennies to be able to make any money. Some of the older ones with this clamshell, that's what this is called. Some of the older ones are worth more than others. I can't remember which ones. It's been so long. But again, you know, if you're in the business and, you know, you want to get lots of stuff, you know, like this is all in Spanish, so it would be nothing to me. But again, you know, if you can put yourself in a position where you can own DVDs for 25, 50 cents a piece and they're actually remotely popular and in good shape, you know, you can do a ton of buy it nows, list, you know, a couple thousand of them on there and, you know, sell them one at a time. A lot of people do that, so that could be part of your business as well. Sometimes if you can find these older 8-tracks, how about $5? You're killing me.
$9.
Hey, I was just talking to a guy at his little booth here, and he's got a bunch of Obama suck stuff. So I talked him into giving me a free one. So he did, because I walked over and I saw that he had some toilet paper. Oh no, wait, that's a Obama shirt. Sorry about that. Okay, we got our haul back to today. It's been about 4 hours there. I really did this more for you guys than I did it for myself, because I don't come to the swap meet too often. It's not a bad place to get stuff. You get lucky once in a while that come out here, but then, you know, they're trying to make a buck, so their guys bought stuff at garage sales too that come out here to the swap meet to sell. The swap meet can be a really good avenue for you guys. to sell. I know one thing, man, I used to make bank back at the swap meet there when I did estate cleanouts. I'd be home by 10 o'clock in the morning with $400 or $500 in my pocket on a Saturday or Sunday morning. So, and we'll figure out what the take is from today, or what the estimated value is, and hopefully made a little bit of money. Hopefully you learned something. I tried to put a couple things in there for you to see, and I'm just doing this for you guys. You guys are asking for this, so here it is. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching, man. I appreciate your guys' support out there, and be grateful and thank God for what you have.
The Intellivision games, I wound up getting, let's see, there's 2, 4, 6 for $4. I did find one. Somebody was selling for $3. I only paid a quarter for it. So, but one guy just did, the one table that I was showing you guys all the rings and stuff like that. I just kept looking over his table. He had like Buffalo nickels, and you know, he just wanted too much money for them. But I found these old glasses. These are, you know, people buy these and put their own lenses in them. And these are definitely vintage from the 60s. I did my research. And then I found a naughty matchbook. I'm not going to show this, but you fold it up and it's risque. Let's just put it that way. For this little pile right here. $1 for each pair of glasses, and I paid a dime for the matchbook. So, you know, let's just call it, $3, okay? And then, you guys saw my Obama suck sticker. not to copy the MasterCard people, but you know what? I got this for free, and the value is absolutely priceless. I saw me do the reel. There it is. It's a Mitchell 702 saltwater. A 302 salt water. I thought it was a 702, but it just needs some cleaning. So this is going to be a $30 to a $50 reel, depending on the buyer, the timing, and the condition on how it's listed. So definitely a nice profit right there. I paid $10 for that one. Okay, now these miserable Bionicles. I bought the whole box. I did pay $50 for everything. But there's just the pile. I weighed it and it came out to be about 20 pounds of Bionicles, but I've not completely gone through them. And there are a bunch of complete ones. The rest of them are kind of parts kind of thing, but you know, that's the way it is. So I'm going to put a value on these of at least about $100. So I'm going to, you know, double my money right there. And for the swap meet, now I do want to do a, let me turn around here.
do a little follow-up on a couple other things you saw. I wound up going back and getting that sign. I told you I was going to the Bud bow tie sign, even though it didn't work. The more I thought about it and researched it, the bow ties were selling, but that thing had on tap on the bottom of it, which told me that was definitely old. So that could have been even as far back as the early 60s, maybe even the late 50s. I'm not sure, but I know it was old. I broke down and paid the guy 15 bucks for it. When I got it home, I put it on Craigslist for 75 bucks, and it popped in, I don't know, maybe an hour and a half, 2 hours. So I got rid of that. Other deal was when I was looking at the car insignias, you know, the signs, the fender emblems and stuff like that. He wanted 30 bucks for everything. I went back and offered him 20. I don't want to piece those things out. That's just not me. So anyways, I threw those on Craigslist and I got 50 bucks for everything. So a $30 profit there. So I've almost paid for everything that I bought yesterday. I think my total was like about 105 bucks. For the whole sale for the day. So as you can see, you know, do the math. I'm going to make a couple hundred dollars off of this pull, and that was about 4 hours of work. Yeah, I may have to put a little more time and effort into it. Let's call it another hour doing some cleaning, but, you know, to go out and work 5 hours and net profit, you know, 200, maybe even a little bit more, I'm hoping. I don't know where you can go get a job like that. So anyways, that's what you're capable of doing out here. If you go out and hustle, you know what to look for. So hey, be grateful for what you have. If you work hard, do things right, good things will happen to you. So I hope everybody's having a great day, and we'll talk to you soon.